Hi, this is Ken from Homebrew Audio. Last time, I showed you how to use overdubbing to fix mistakes as you go along, stopping right after you first mess up, setting up a second fix track, and continuing the recording. Then you join them up when you're done. This time, I'll show you how to fix a problem after the track is fully recorded. The process is actually really similar. In this example, I have a completed guitar track, but I notice when I'm listening to it, that right there in this area, I have a buzzing sound on the strings, which I would like to replace. So I need to record a bit of the part containing that chord and then basically patch the mistake in the original track. So just like before, I disarm the original track to make sure that I don't record over the original guitar. And I arm the second track, the fixed track, for recording. And I come a little bit before the mistake, starting here so that I'm far enough back to be able to start playing along. Then I play through the mistake and then play a little bit after it. Then when you're done recording, disarm the fixed track. Now you see that I've already created this recording here, this sort of patch recording. So next, you want to put your cursor just before the string buzzing, right there. It'll sound more natural if you use a point just before a strum. See this thick blob right here? That represents a down strum on the guitar. So if you put your cursor right before that and then split the track by hitting the S key on your keyboard, and now you just drag the left edge of the audio on the right. So you want the cursor to look like this, a double arrowhead with lines on the right side of it only. If you put the cursor right between the two audio items, you'll get this with lines on both sides. You don't want that. This is the one you want. So just click and drag. And I'm going to drag until the mistake is gone. Basically, I create a hole in the audio by peeling back the mistake, just sort of peel it away. And then I come down to the fixed track and I'm just going to drag the left edge of this in and the right edge in to match the hole in the original audio. And then all I have to do is drag it up, and remember, leave little overlaps on either side for crossfading. And you've patched your audio. It's perfectly seamless, and it's like the mistake never happened. And that's how you fix a mistake in the middle of a performance that's already been recorded.